After getting swept in the first round of the playoffs this season versus the Celtics, are they still an elite franchise in the East? Should they still trust the process, or is it time for change in Philadelphia? After a very impressive playoff run last season and only being knocked out by Kawhi's insane Game 7 buzzer beater, many people would have expected them to have another good playoff run and at least get out the first round. But what adds insult to injury for the Sixers is that if they beat the Raptors in the East Conference Finals, they would have likely won in the Finals as well, as the Warriors were stricken with injuries. They lost DeMarcus Cousins in Game 2 against the Clippers, who was just back from a torn left Achilles. Kevin Durant re-injured his ACL in Game 1 and was out for the rest of the series, and Klay struggled with injuries throughout the whole series, injuring his leg in Game 2 and his ACL in Game 6. And even with his blown ACL, he managed to get back out onto the court and still shoot his free throws and even tried to carry on. And while the Klay Thompson injury may not have occurred as he was healthy beforehand, Durant and Cousins would have both likely re-injured themselves still, as this was Durant's first game back from his injury as well. And if the Sixers won the championship last season, I think it's unlikely that Jimmy Butler would have left, and him and Embiid would have made an effort to work together. So it's crazy to think how much Kawhi's buzzer beater has impacted the league, as we wouldn't have seen Jimmy on the Heat, and wouldn't have the Heat in the finals right now. But going back to the Sixers, they decided to fire Brett Brown after coaching for 7 years, and after getting swept by the Celtics, I kind of understand the board's decision. And with now signing Doc Rivers to a 5-year deal, can he turn the team around? Even with Jimmy leaving to Miami, they still have their two young stars, Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons. And while Joel Embiid is one of the most exciting NBA players to watch due to his taunting, trash-talking and charisma, it can't be overlooked how in his 6-year NBA career, he's only played 232 games, and that's regular season and playoff games combined. And this is due to the many injuries he's had over the years, including a foot injury that sidelined him for his first two NBA seasons. Even so, he's one of the best centers in the NBA currently, with his strong post-game, great handles and a solid three-point shot of 32% for his career. And on the other end, he's one of the best defensive centers in the league, with his excellent shot-blocking ability and lateral quickness to stay in front of his man. Moving on to Ben Simmons, he's one of the most interesting players in the NBA. In a league where the three-point shot is the most prominent it's ever been, he's the only starting NBA point guard that can't shoot whatsoever. But on the other hand, he does so many great things on the offensive end, as he's one of the best guards at driving to the basket and forces teams to change how they play defensively, as no team is used to guarding a 6'10 point guard. And it's not as simple as if you just sit off him to get him to shoot, as you're only going to give him more room to work with. What you do need to do with Ben though is surround him with great spot-up shooters, which they have in Tobias Harris, for him to kick the ball out to after sucking in the D. And it seems that they still plan on building around Ben, as they drafted Ryan Brockhoff and Shake Milton 2 seasons ago, and they both have a phenomenal 40% from three so far in the NBA. And Shake Milton looks to have a very bright future ahead of him, averaging 22 points per game over a 5-year stretch last season, and getting a career high of 39 points in a close playoff loss to the Clippers. So for next season, I don't really know where to predict the Sixers to finish. I think their floor could be as low as the 7th seed, but their ceiling as high as the 2nd. But as long as Embiid doesn't get any major injuries, I think they'll do just fine.